Now, here is the flag of Alaska State, and this is the state seal. Now, the Alaskan flag was designed in 1927, 32 years before it became a state, and it consists of 8 golden stars on a blue background. 7 of the 8 stars are arranged like the Big Dipper constellation, which you can see in Alaska, while the other star is larger and in the top right corner of the flag. Now, the blue symbolizes the Alaskan sky and the official flower of Alaska, the forget-me-not. The Big Dipper symbolizes strength, like that of the bear of Ursa Major, the constellation which the Big Dipper is a part of. And the other star represents Polaris, another star in the sky, commonly called the North Star. And it symbolizes the future state of Alaska, being the most northerly. Now, this makes sense as this flag was designed before Alaska even became a state. So that this star symbolizes the, at that time, future state of Alaska makes sense. Next, Alaska's official state bird is the willow ptarmigan. Note the word ptarmigan with a P at the beginning, which is silent. And the official Alaskan state flower is the forget-me-not, as mentioned earlier. The state tree is the Sitka spruce, the land mammal is the moose, and the marine mammal is the bowhead whale. Now, the state fish is the king salmon, and the state motto is North to the Future. Now, the nickname of the state is the Last Frontier, and the two-letter code is AK. Unlike other US states, Alaska isn't divided into counties. Rather, it's divided into boroughs. Yeah, boroughs, not exactly like New York City boroughs. Here they function pretty much like counties do. Alas, the 19 boroughs primarily cover densely populated parts of the state. But Alaska's boroughs don't even cover the entire land area of the state. The area which isn't part of any borough is referred to collectively as the unorganized borough. The U.S. Census Bureau divided this unorganized borough into 11 census areas. Now, most of Alaska follows U.S. Alaskan time, which is Coordinated Universal Time, UTC, minus 9 hours. So, Alaskan time is U.S. Pacific time minus 1 hour. But the Western Aleutian Islands actually observe Hawaiian Aleutian time, which is 1 hour behind the remainder of the state, so it's 2 hours behind Pacific. Now, with an estimated population of over 731,000 people in 2020, Alaska is the third least populous state in the US after Wyoming and Vermont, and it is the most sparingly populated state, with just 1.2 inhabitants per square mile. Now, approximately half of its population lives within the Anchorage metro area. Alaska's native Indian population is significantly high at over 15% compared to any US state, and they exercise considerable influence in both local and state politics. In 2014, Alaska governor signed the bill which gives the official language status to 20 of its native indigenous languages. Now, let's take a look at the history of this state. The history of human arrival in Alaska's region dates all the way back to at least 14,000 BC, when foraging groups crossed the Bering Land Bridge and settled into what is now Western Alaska. Note that this used to be a land bridge. Soon this all sunk down, and now you see this as the Bering Strait. Now, Alaska was considered the entry point for the settlement of North America by way of this Bering Land Bridge. The Russians were the first Europeans to settle the area beginning in the 18th century. I mean, they're close enough to the area. The expense and difficulty of maintaining this distant possession for the Russians prompted its sale to the US in 1867 for $7.2 million at the time. Now, Alaska was a US territory for quite a while before it was finally admitted as the 49th state of the US on January 3rd, 1959. Now, Alaska has one of the smallest state economies in the country, yet its per capita income is actually among the highest, owing to a quite diversified economy dominated by fishing, natural gas, and oil, all of which has an abundance. Alaska's 2020 GDP is just $52 billion, and the per capita income is $64,780, as per the US Bureau of Economic Analysis. Now, Alaska's economy is primarily dependent on three sectors: the petroleum and gas industry, the federal government, and the industries and service sector. The 1968 discovery of oil at Prudhoe Bay and the 1977 completion of the Trans-Alaska Pipeline System led to an oil boom in the region, owing to the royalty revenues from oil, which funded large state budgets since 1980. Alaska repealed its state income tax entirely. Now, the United States federal government provides over 130,000 jobs in Alaska through its offices and armed forces bases. Federal subsidies also play an important role in Alaska's economy as well. Because of its cold climatic conditions, agriculture represents only a very small fraction of the Alaskan economy. After oil and natural gas, the main export product from Alaska is seafood, especially salmon and crab. The industries sector includes crude petroleum, natural gas, coal, gold, precious metals, zinc, and other mining, seafood processing, timber, and wood products. And the tourism sector is flourishing in Alaska right now and contributes significantly to the state's economy. Thanks so much for watching. Love you, Akash.